leader in sports for Andy Myers and our entire crew. Mike Patrick, thanks for watching. Let's go back to the studio.
We are going to go. Paige Sauer and Olympia Scott will tip it up. Both these teams really like to get the ball running, but I think it would benefit Stanford if they could get Connecticut in a half-court game. Heather Owen looking inside Olympia Scott and turns it over. Stanford automatically looking inside at their post players, which has been the strength of the team this year. This year, which Connecticut probably in the last 8 years have been known for their inside game. Now with the graduation of Carol Walters and Rebecca Lobo, they have Paige Sauer, but she plays a little bit more outside. Hansmeyer back out. To Nakisha Sales, who saw the Huskies had no problem with the pressure applied by Stanford. So Rita Williams will back it up with 10 seconds left on the shot clock. And really a good matchup. Nygaard just got picked off, and Nakisha Sales got open off the pick. But those two are very good defensive players, Nygaard and Sales, against each other.
Nygaard getting the rebound from the Sales miss.
Rita Williams all over Melody Peterson and called for the first foul. And that's one player that Gino Auriemma cannot afford to get into foul trouble. Amy Duran averages over 30 minutes a game. Nakisha Sales steps into that point guard position when Rita Williams has to go out.
Both still looking for the first point of the game. Olympia Scott is going to be called for the offensive foul. Trying to make a little space there.
And this has been Olympia Scott's downfall. She's a senior. She's fouled out of three games. A little shove with the elbow right there for the offensive foul. And she said to us yesterday in practice, she goes, I will stay in the game. I'm working on not getting into foul trouble.
Paige Sauer doing a good job of getting position. Looking inside, this Hansmeyer working on Olympia Scott. Back out to Nakisha Sales for three. That's money. Heather Owen driving. Nice touch by Heather Owen.
Heather Owen averages over 11 points a game, but she really even has to step up scoring more.
Again, no problem breaking the pressure, but the miss off of Peterson.
Stanford has always been known for a team that likes to run the ball and get quick shots in the transition.
Peterson tried to do that, but Hansmeyer with the rebound.
Even though they miss shots, they feel, Tarvandre feels that if they can get the opponent running, that they will get tired and take poor percentage shots also.
Looking inside to Hansmeyer, working on Olympia Scott. The foul away goes.
Good ball movement by Connecticut, just really passing the ball around the perimeter, and Hansmeyer wide open with a nice move inside.
From the corner, Vanessa Nygaard, too hard. Long rebound out to Hansmeyer. Rita Williams, if you give her the space, she'll do it. 50 doodle, but too hard. Connecticut. Peterson takes the three and ties the game.
One question mark for Stanford this year coming in was their backcourt. They graduated Kate Starberg and Jamila Weidman and Charmin Smith, and Peterson and Milena Flores stepping up.
Amy Duran to Nakisha Sales. 10 seconds on the shot clock. She'll make her move. Good hands by Flores and Peterson, and the turnover they cause.
Even though Nakisha Sales got called for the double dribble, she had the lane wide open. In the past, when Carol Walters at 6'7 was in there, it really kind of clogged things up, and Connecticut always could dump it inside to the big girl. Now things have opened up in the middle a little bit more for them.
Good hands by Nakisha Sales.
Another steal.
Number 24 for this year. Paige Sauer with a turnaround. Quick hands there by Nakisha Sales, but she's going to be called for her first foul.
Looked like a good steal, but she slapped down on the ball, and that's where she gets called for the foul. We talked about how good her defense is, but she can also shoot the outside shot. Good little inside-outside game right here. Sales positioning herself to an open spot where Nygaard cannot get to her, and just nice, patience, wide-open shot.
Looking inside to Olympia Scott. Vanessa Nygaard, a big offensive rebound. Scott reloads too hard to Hansmeyer.
Yesterday in practice, Tara Vanderveer told her team, you've got to go at them and try and draw fouls.
Amy Duran to offer hands. So it'll be Stanford's ball.
Number 25.
First substitutions of the game. For Gina Oyama. Svetlana Abrasimova coming in for Amy Duran. And folks, you're in for a treat. She's only 17 years old. She's from Russia. And she can play some basketball.
Last summer's European champions, MVP.
Olympia Scott creating, but it's called for walking.
One thing Olympia Scott gets called for a lot on her turnovers, she leads the team in turnovers, is because of her traveling calls. Looked like a nice pivot. Stanford staying in the man, and Connecticut's been playing the zone.
Abrasimova looking inside the hands, Meyer. 3 seconds is the call.
She's really, really good. We're very difficult to play against. When she's not going good, we're just an ordinary team. The difficult part is trying to figure out where she is because she doesn't say anything. She comes from a system where there's no talking. They don't talk on the court. They communicate non-verbally. Well, that's hard for our kids to get used to. So she's trying to fill that gap there between where she was and where we need her to be.
Of course, Abrasimova from Russia. I guess she won't talk to Gino. That's right. But Gino talks the universal language with his hands and everything. But
in Italian.
She has been a pleasant acquisition for the Huskies. Again, averaging almost 14 points a game. Quick hands by Rita Williams, knocks it out of bounds. It'll still be Stanford's ball with 21 seconds on the shot clock.
Connecticut has done a good job on the 2-3 zone. They've really spread themselves out. Yesterday in practice, they worked on Rita Williams up top, sagging down in the middle when it went down low, because that's where the strength is for Stanford. And Mimi Griffin just came over and told us that in the huddle for Stanford, they need to rotate the ball a little bit more, pass it. Here they got it inside with more passes on the perimeter.
Olympia Scott. Stanford's first lead. Slashing is sailed, but misses to Scott.
And when you play against a zone, you just have to be more patient, but they're telegraphing their passes. Melinda Forrest up top has gotten the ball tipped about 3 or 4 times by the Connecticut defenders. They have to be at least a little bit crisper passes or shorter passes or make a fake and then pass the ball.
Across it over right there, almost came up with another steal. Vanessa Nygaard for three. Increasing Stanford's lead. It's biggest lead, 5 points. Inside the hands, Meyer is going to be called for pushing off. And the offensive foul.
Connecticut really struggling in their offense right now. They're only getting 1 or 2 passes. They're trying to get some cuts to the basket, but they just need to be a little bit more patient. And we talked about, you see Gino Auriemma, he's a little tired of the way they're playing offense right now, but they need to be patient in the offense. They're not as good a half-court team as they are in the transition.
Flores for three! Now all of a sudden, Stanford seems very comfortable, and Gino wants to take a 20-second timeout.
Well, in that zone, they're spreading it out on top, but they're leaving the baselines open, and Vanessa Nygaard hit a three-pointer, and now you see Melina Flores hitting a three-pointer because they're so concerned about the inside players of Stanford.
Now an 8-point lead for the Cardinal. Of course, you're going to see great basketball here on ESPN and ESPN2 with the Honda Elite 4 Classic, but you can see great hoop action night after night after night after night on full-court pay-per-view for only $89. What a season gift, huh? Hundreds of extra hoop games for the Big Ten, Big East, ACC, SEC, Conference USA, Big 12, more. Order today. Call DirecTV at 1-800-GET-SPORTS or your local cable company. Your college basketball dreams come true on ESPN Full Court Pay-Per-View.
Stay awake.
I tell you what, and any of my family members listening and they haven't gotten me a gift yet, that will be just fine. Just fine. I'd like that.
Don't tell my kids about it. Stanford going into their own zone now.
Yeah. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Abrasimova gets it over to Paige Sauer. And the steal by Nakisha Sales. And the ball movement. Hansmeier benefits.
the pressure defense in the front court. Stanford, we talked about their youth. They turned it over. Tennessee in the second half, they really struggled against them, turning the ball over.
Trying to get it, and it does go from Melody Peterson. How'd she get this to go down?
They don't ask how, they just ask how many.
She's not afraid to put it up.
Well, she is the one player that Tara Vanderveer feels that really worked in the offseason and got herself better.
Paige Sauer is going to be called for the offensive foul. Good positioning there by Owen.
Last year, Carol Walters did not foul out of a game, and Gino Auriemma was
there. He promised before the season.
And there you see Paige Sauer with the step. She was already making her move. You know, you let it go, but it doesn't matter. Paige Sauer gets the foul. But also another key player that doesn't get recognized probably as much, Carla Berube, who is a solid four player. And that's a position that Gino Auriemma has always had. Jamil Elliott, who's an assistant this year, was in that position and was a solid player for them. And they're a strong rebounder, not just off of Carol Walters or Rebecca Lobo.
Coming in for Gino Auriemma, Kelly Hunt, and also Amy Duran back in the game. Comes away with a steal.
Kelly Hunt, the senior, has a lot of experience. Nice move.
Well, knocked out of bounds. Stanford's ball.
Well, they call her Spencer short, but she really makes the good international step to the side to try and get that shot off.
Well, Flores was wide open down the court, but Peterson couldn't see her.
Talk about tempo of the game and a transition game. Connecticut would like to run, but right now, Stanford in the half-court game doing a good job controlling the tempo.
Svetlana Abrasova was called for the foul. And now the first substitution for Tara Vanderveer. As Olympia Scott takes a seat, and Regan Fruin, comes in for the Cardinal. Owen baseline, nice move to the baseline for Owen. Looking to shoot the basketball a little bit more. Now an 8-point advantage, the key to Sales. Fruin, good defense from behind, and Kelly Hunt's going to be called for the foul.
Even though Nikisha Sales misses that layup, Robin, it really is a wonderful move. She gets the ball, and quickly that first step, she is off and running to the basket. She is so good attacking and being aggressive going to the basket. She misses a shot, and then it's just a play right here for Stanford. Kelly Hunt out of position and gets called for the foul.
The touch foul.
Yeah. Been there.
Haven't we all? Heather Owen, top of the key, decides to get it back out to Peterson. In Connecticut, into the man-to-man, trying to switch things up. A little confusion, the back door by Flores.
Well, they stopped a three-point shot by going into the man-to-man, but they left the middle open.
Stanford's biggest lead, 10 points. Abrasova cutting into it. Now under 12 to go, 19-11 in favor of Stanford. Ball is kicked. Going to be Stanford's ball still. And we have a timeout on the floor with Stanford.
Connecticut has, they are bringing the ball high, and watch Paige Sauer in the middle at 6'5". She is guarding her player, does not have a clue where the weak side defense is, and has to step in. You saw where her head was turned. Number 41 was taking the ball out of bounds. She has to be weak side help, and otherwise that back door does not happen. So they're going to have to be much more aware of Connecticut is on the defensive end, on clogging that middle up and helping on the weak side.
Melody Peterson and Flores, the backcourt, coming through with 10 of their 19 points.
Vanderveer's got to be happy about that.
Inside to Owen, the spin move, and it's fouled, and it goes. Paige Sauer calls for the foul. So Owen will go to the line, 65% free throw shooter.
Stanford has created one-on-one situations. Nice pass inside. They look for a double team, but Owen with a nice spin move inside. And you see three blue jerseys there, but two of them are too late helping out.
And so Paige Sauer will go to the bench with her second foul.
Anderson the rebound. Sales almost with another steal. It's going to go to Connecticut.
It is.
A cardinal sin as far as letting the defensive team come in for that rebound off the free throw.
But still, Nikisha Sales gets it back for Connecticut. Kelly Schumacher coming in place of Paige Sauer. Schumacher at 6'5". Amy Duran, good head fake there.
That's it for Amy Duran.
Still an 8-point advantage. Ruin, though, with a three. For Stanford. Approaching the 11-minute mark here in the first half. Nikisha Sales knocks down the three.
For Nikisha Sales.
Fast and furious now.
All right, I'm trying to keep score.
Watch the game.
Okay,
forget about
okay.
the score.
Back out to Fruin. Owen is going to be called for traveling. Williams is set to come back in for Amy Duran.
Here's that inside-outside game, and what happens, the ball goes inside, and Connecticut is really doing a good job cutting on the weak side. Stanford really getting caught. That's about the second or third time that's happened for Connecticut.
Sales again for three.
You definitely cannot leave Nikisha Sales open from the three-point range. Three three-pointers already.
Applying a little pressure in the backcourt. Looking inside, but gets it across to Fruin. Again for three, this time off the mark, and across him over the rebound.
And Connecticut going into the zone, forcing Stanford to take the outside shot, and hopefully coming up with a defensive rebound.
Good defense by Regan Fruin. Vanessa Nygaard and Hansmeyer. It's going to be Connecticut's ball.
Vanessa Nygaard wanted a bounce pass, a hard bounce pass, but look at how the defense is just sagging off. That's a tough pass to get in from that angle. You have to have the defense come up on you or make them commit to you so you can get a better angle for that post, that pass to the post.
It was clearly off of Nygaard. Connecticut back to within five. 9.5 to go here in the first half. Hansmeyer setting the screen for Sales over to Rita Williams. Sales looking for a shot again. This time a little off the mark. Cardinal Woodrow, let's see a stop.
A two-on-one situation. Good passing by the Cardinal.
Rolling to the basket, but not being seen by Abrasimova.
They had the play, you're right.
Schumacher coming off, but still it's Olympia Scott with the board, but quickly down to Peterson. And the blocking foul is called on Rita Williams. We're in Lakeland, Florida for the Honda Elite Four Holiday Classic. I don't, Robert Roberts, Annie Myers, Mimi Griffin. I feel weird saying
Oh, yeah, it's Okay, I'll say Robin Roberts.
Peterson goes to the line. 59% free throw shooter.
Last year, Peterson only played 81 minutes in 23 games, which averages about a little over 3 minutes. And now she has become a starter in the backcourt and averaging almost 28 minutes a game.
Just a second team foul by Stanford. Schumacher is off the mark.
Connecticut only getting one shot at the basket, Robin. Stanford's doing a good job and then getting their transition game going.
And you see Vanessa Nygaard from the other side, same result, knocking down the three. And so Stanford playing with a lot of confidence.
takes an 11-point lead, its biggest in the game.
You know, you had asked Gino Auriemma earlier in the week on our conference call about the 10-day layoff, whether it would hurt them or not. And good patience by Stanford. They look fresh. They have been here in Orlando since
UMass. He didn't mind the 10-game layoff, 10-day layoff, because they knew they were going to play Stanford. And you know, you can't take a team like that for granted, even though they come in here with a 2-3 record.
Exactly. And you hope that your team will be hungry to play in this kind of game. They have played four times. Stanford leads the series 3-1, but the last time they played, and you see the field goal percentage, Stanford, and a lot of it's layups, but they're hitting a lot of three-pointers, 71%. The last time they played, Connecticut won in the Final Four 2 years ago when they went undefeated and won the championship.
And in many games this year, Connecticut has gotten off to a slow start like this. Rita Williams off. Nikisha Sales, one of the rare offensive rebounds in the back.
It's one of the few times she's been found underneath the basket, Nikisha Sales. There she is around the basketball trying
always
to come up with a steal.
Stuck the school's all-time chaos.
Connecticut switching things around, putting Nikisha Sales down low to get some offensive boards, because we talked about Connecticut not getting the boards and only one shot at the basket. That time off the missed shot, she got the offensive bucket.
Nikisha Sales with 11 of their 21 first half points.
And a very low-scoring game right now for Connecticut. Three games this year they've been held under 70 points. They've won, and two games they've scored over 100 points. But they're not getting the good shot selection in this first half so far.
Stanford showing patience when it has to. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Flores off the mark, but Peterson, a big offensive rebound. And a fresh 30. Peterson driving the baseline. Too hard. Olympia Scott has it stripped. Good defense by the Huskies. Rita Williams for three. Scott is fouled, going for the rebound.
We talked about Carl Vanderbilt, you did earlier, as far as being an Olympic coach for 96, and Amy Tucker took over the team, and as a matter of fact, Amy Tucker took the team to the Final Four, so they've been to three straight Final Fours, but Tara Vanderveer's international experience and what she's taken from the international game as far as running the transition. You talk about Stanford getting back on the defensive end because they know when they don't get the offensive rebound, they get back quickly because that's from the international game. And another thing is their post players are very versatile. They're able to come outside and face the basket, and they're very physical.
Facing the basket, Sales, but off the mark to Heather Owen. So again, one trip down, one shot, and back the other way for Connecticut.
Oh, good hands!
But can't control it.
Kelly Hunt coming over for the weak side. We talked about weak side earlier that Connecticut was getting hurt. That time, Kelly Hunt, seeing the ball going inside, was all over it.
Nygaard quickly putting it up in the air ball. And Rita Williams has it knocked away, but gets it back. Cutting Rita Williams. And boy, what body control. Gets it to go and it's fouled.
I like that play a lot. Off the short post, the weak side, they come back. And you have the guard cutting off. It's almost like a backdoor. So it's a give and go, basically. Nice bounce pass to the high post. Rita Williams is going. As soon as the pass is there, the defense cannot recover. There's no weak side help. Flores was just left in the dust.
And Rita Williams converts the old-fashioned three-point play. And Sales, but quick hands again. Almost comes away with the steal. Flores, a good job of protecting the ball. Cannot show Nikisha Sales the ball. Hansmeier. No, she's not called. It's an offensive foul on Olympia Scott. That's her second. Remember, she has fouled out of three of Stanford's five games this season. Connecticut back to within six.
And has been in foul trouble, not with just the foul outs. There's that back door again.
foul.
It's an Olympia Scott. That's going to be her third.
It is. And quickly she picks up two fouls and has three. And you'd have to imagine she's going to the sideline.
And this is always a plus, Robin. There you see the back door. Olympia Scott really got caught up high and then comes back down. She's underneath the basket. And really kind of a no-call when you're underneath the basket, but she picks up that third foul. Stacey Hansmeyer just did a good job cutting to the basket.
Making the first two.
Put somebody on me.
You see Olympia Scott going out with her third foul. And Regan Fruin coming back in, and she was very effective a short time ago for the Cardinals.
Hansmeyer just really a hard-nosed player and gained a lot of experience on the junior national team this summer.
Sarah Dimson coming in as well.
Foul number 22.
And that's the first foul on Amy Duran.
In her first penalty situation.
In a bonus situation now. And so Sarah Dimson will go to the line, a freshman from Norman, Oklahoma. Actually, she played with the same high school team as Stacey Hansmeyer of Connecticut. What a state title in 2 days. Stacey senior year. Dimson, this is the first of two. Defensive efforts. Under six to go here in the first half.
Stanford, that's the first point Stanford has scored in 3 minutes.
A lot of movement. A quick flat pass to Rossimova, who's going to be called for walking.
Connecticut has really picked things up on the offensive end, though. They're passing the ball. They're looking for the cutters. They're very active in their offense now instead of standing around.
Yeah. 11 turnovers for Stanford, just 7 for Connecticut. Flores inside the good, denying defense by Kelly Hunt. Sparking the fast break to across the Mova.
And the defensive end, Kelly Hunt, made it all happen. Taking care of the basketball, that's what Stanford needs to do, and they don't do it again. A long pass.
Doing a good job of getting a hand on it, but Hansmeyer stays with it. And Tara Vandeveer with a 20-second timeout. The lead has dwindled to just 2 for Stanford.
We're going to miss the defensive end as far as knocking the ball away, but Rita Williams bringing the ball into the middle, spreading the defense, making them commit a nice pass to Brasanova with a good concentrated layup.
This is the first of 2 games here from the Lakeland Center at 7 p.m. Eastern on ESPN2. The Deuce, Iowa, who won the Big Ten tournament last year, will go up against Vanderbilt with only 1 loss on the year. That's Iowa, number 8 Vanderbilt, coming up tonight, 7 p.m. Eastern, over on ESPN2. Part of the inaugural Honda Elite Four Holiday Classic.
You know, Paige Sauer is in foul trouble, but I think the substitution by Gino Auriemma with Kelly Hunt in the game, 6'2 senior, she's a little bit more active defensively and quick with her feet to get around and has gotten a hand on those passes.
Rita Williams getting a bit of a break. The team down by 2. Vanessa Nygaard shooting a 3, gets her own miss, and stays with it on the baseline. Gina Auriemma is very animated on the sideline about that.
Since the scoring streak, Connecticut has spread the ball around and gotten other players involved in the offense.
Hansmeyer, too hard. Fruin comes away with it. And look at the hands of Nakisha Sales, causing that turnover.
You know what you call sweet? Just made the defense drop off her, made a little juke and jive move, and just pulled back, and nice and easy 3.
She's taken more of a leadership role here in her senior year at Connecticut. Stanford with a 2-point lead, under 4 to go. Away from the ball. The foul is called on Stanford. and Vanessa Nygaard. We have a timeout on the floor with Connecticut down by two, under four to go. And three record. They've played a very difficult schedule, and they now feel that maybe they've found their way.
So right now, I think our team is kind of finding its identity, but when it's all said and done, I think this is going to be a team that, you know, maybe starts out, it's not a smooth ride, but it's been a bumpy one, but it's going to be a great one when it's all said and done, because we have a very talented team, and they're working very hard, and they're enjoying the challenge.
And right now, it's Connecticut enjoying a 9-2 run over Tara Vanderveer's team in the last 3.5 minutes.
I think Tara Vanderveer has enjoyed the challenge, too. You know, she lost three starters. Muli Taupele was a starter all year last year, Weidman and Starbird, and now she's just waiting and salivating for Kristen Fogel to come back, because she led the team in rebounding last year with only 16 games.
Inside sails. The tough basket. She now has 15.
What a pretty move by Nikisha Sales. Just under control, a little body contact, and good concentration.
Tied ball game. As we approach the half, on the floor, before the basket.
And really,
her third foul.
Sorry, Robin. Not a bad foul by Kelly Hunt, because within the offense, Stanford, if they get that, score that basket, they kind of get into a run and feel
right.
Comfortable about their offense. Now it stops play, and it's like, oh, you really didn't score the basket.
Oh, it is a 65% free throw shooter. And this is the first two.
And foul from the can't shoot.
That's a bonus. Oh, yeah. We forgot that one. Back to a one-point advantage for Stanford. Looking inside to Nikisha Sales, who did a good job of gathering the ball and knowing where she was underneath the basket.
They really had a great mismatch, Robin. Peterson was on her, she was switched off, and size-wise, she will not be able to take Nikisha Sales down low.
And the turnover, just a little miscommunication there between Owen and Vanessa Nygaard.
There you see Peterson going down with Nikisha Sales. Nikisha Sales at 6 foot and has good hops, can get up to the ball and then gets it up into the basket.
Give credit to Kelly Hunt for seeing that, and a steal taken by
Nikisha with a little reach over.
Oh, just a little bit. So she's used to stealing the ball. She's not used to it being taken from her, and she's called for the foul. That's her second. And so Peterson will go to the line.
From the free throw line. The one person you want to foul or don't foul is Vanessa Nygaard, but Nygaard doesn't get to the line that much.
She's a 94%. She's not there, but touch her. Peterson making one of two. 4 or 5 games, she has been in double figures for Stanford this year. Coming off a season high, or had a season high, 18 against Wisconsin. Amy Duran driving. Going inside to Kelly Hunt, back out to Nikisha Sales. Good step right there, off glass, but too hard. Heather Owen rips it down. Peterson doing a good job of getting down the floor, and Moore is finding her.
A 3-on-2 situation, up tempo. That's the international game that Tara Vanderveer likes to teach.
Dumping it to Amy Duran, but maybe. She should have taken the shot hands by her. A little too close.
A little out of position. She was off balance and then knew she couldn't get the shot off and tried to look down low. Nygaard now guarding Abrazimova. And Peterson, we talked about being on Nikisha Sales. And she definitely has her work cut out for her.
And the 6'6 Carolyn Moos, a freshman, seeing her first action for Stanford.
Connecticut has done a better job on the offensive end, getting some second opportunities.
Kelly Hunt! Woo! Forget that she's a senior also. Gives Gina Oriema some quality minutes. What poise by Flores.
In going with the youngsters for Stanford, obviously those are the players that Flores and Peterson, both sophomores. Flores saw more action last year behind Jamila Weidman. But you go in with the youngsters, and you live and die by them, and you get the experience. And they're going to be out in the backcourt for Tara Vanderveer all season long.
Hensmeyer was called for her second foul. A three-point advantage again for Stanford. Applying some pressure now on Connecticut. Keisha Sale, another give and go.
Easy game, isn't it?
You play it like that. Carolyn moves off the mark. So Brasimova.
Probably not great shot selection with Moons at 6'6 taking an outside shot.
Brasimova! So quick to the basket.
And they take the lead
with under a minute to go here in the first half. Good position there by Heather Owen. Just seconds left to go here in the first half. Abrasimova, too hard. Hensmeyer in the right place and is fouled by Moose. NFL action. There are four playoff spots left in the NFL. Six teams vying for those four spots. Also, women's top 25 scores. And we'll update you on Patrick Ewing, his situation with the Knicks about possible surgery. Again, a 50% free throw shooter. Sarah Dimson coming back in, replacing Moose. Tying the score yet again.
It's really been a game of streaks, some good defensive plays to get Connecticut back in it, and then some patience on offense. Stanford being held to their three-point shots. They hit a streak, hitting those three-pointers and some layups, and then have struggled from the offensive end.
Heather Owen, the turnaround off glass. Here's seconds left. And Abrasimova from half court. Oh, the miss! Oh, they almost let Kelly Hunt do it. But she was off the mark. And so at the half, Stanford leads 44-42 over Nikisha Sales. And the Connecticut Huskies, Sales with 17 first half points. We have a lot coming up at the half here in Lakeland, Florida. When we come back, we'll join ESPN News.
ESPN's presentation beginning to look a lot like Christmas. And as they go at it, FSU up 26-25, 7 seconds left in the half, and Jackie Stiles, the long three-pointer, she's fouled, makes the free throw, 29-26 Southwest Missouri at the half. Second half, Stiles taking the ball to the hole, gets the bucket and the foul. Teammates like that. Southwest Missouri up 5. And then they put it away. Jamie Bartlett nailing the three-pointer, and Southwest Missouri State rolling 68-57 the final. Stiles with 24 points. As far as
they do have balanced scoring, and Connecticut just cannot key on one person.
And remember, Olympia Scott, who starts here in the second half, has three fouls. Vanessa Nygaard overpaid Sauer.
They always want to start out strong as far as hitting that first shot. Connecticut is 8-1 when they've led at halftime, 1-0 when they are down at halftime. This is only the second time they've been down at half.
Even the times they've led at the half, it's been a very slim margin. Rita Williams with the miss, Owen the rebound. And the steal by Williams, the ill-advised shot perhaps, or maybe she was trying to draw the foul. That she hustles back down and knocks it out of bounds.
Peterson thought that she was going to jump up in the air and try and block a shot, and then she tried a little hook pass off the bounce and didn't get it there.
Good hustle by Rita Williams.
Davis in the inbound. Fresh 30. Owen being guarded by Paige Sauer, who's going to be called for the foul. That's going to be her third.
She had two fouls in that second half and sat an awful lot. Kelly Hunt came in.
Foul number 41
for Connecticut. She only had 2 points, but she really made a difference on the defensive end for Connecticut.
She really did. Heather Owen puts it up quickly. Here comes Nikisha Sales. Doesn't really have the numbers. Trying to create. Off to Rita Williams. She's got to kick it back out to Amy Duran. The miss for three. And Paige Sauer is going to be called. They thought it was going to be on Paige. Actually, it was on. It is on Paige Sauer. And that is four fouls. Quickly, two fouls there.
Trying to go for the offensive end. Amy Duran has been held scoreless. She averages just under 8 points. And she, as a senior, she's got to knock down those open shots.
Owen getting position. Lawrence off the mark. But hustles to get the ball back. Heather Owen baseline. And Rita Williams goes crashing to the floor.
Vanessa Nargard said, get out of the way. Oh, they're going to call her Rita Williams.
She's like, wait a minute, I'm on the floor. How could it be? Yeah, I think Rita wants that question answered as well.
Rita Williams.
That's 3 fouls of Rita Williams. And she looks at his bench. Good inbounds play. And the blocking foul on Paige Sauer. And if that is indeed the case, she will be gone. Are you kidding me? I think Gina Auriemma is in disbelief as well. But yes, Paige Sauer has fouled out.
Paige Sauer trying to get over for position. Owen missing her second shot. Two shots she should have put down, even though she was fouled on that.
But why was she kept in with four fouls like that and so much time left here in this game? 18 minutes.
30 seconds.
And she fouls out with just 2 points. Later tonight here on ESPN, Sunday Night Football, 8 p.m. Eastern, right after NFL prime time. San Francisco 49ers already have the home field advantage in the playoffs. They'll take on the Seattle Seahawks. That's 8 p.m. Eastern here on ESPN, the Niners and the Seahawks. Again, Paige Sauer has fouled out with 18 minutes and 18 seconds left to go here in the game with 2 points and 3 quick fouls in under 2 minutes, 3 fouls here in the second half. So Heather Owen will go to the line.
You know, not good for the Huskies to have Paige Sauer at 6'5 unavailable for them, but yet, as we mentioned, that first half, they played well when Kelly Hunt was in there. Also, Kelly Schumacher came in, did some good things. And Amaz Mumba, that's 6'2", and she is very mobile and did a lot of good things. And they're the type of team that is better off in a running type situation with this Stanford team.
Both of them. Olympia Scott went out. She has 3 fouls. She went out and Sarah Dimson came in her place for Stanford. In the first half, we didn't see many whistles or hear many whistles, but now we are on Vanessa Nygaard. That's her second. 6-point advantage for Stanford. They led by 2 at the half. Hensmeyer looking inside, but goes back out to Rita Williams, who drives and has a block by Owen and is called for the foul.
Good penetration by Rita Williams to make the defense come at them. Heather Owen trying to help out. You can see she's up at the high post, number 44. She comes right off that high post, and as Owen drops down, gets a little bit of Rita Williams' arm.
And so Williams will go to the line. 74% free throw shooter. But this is the first.
This is her third year here at Connecticut. She was a transfer from Mitchell Junior College from Connecticut, a junior college All-American, and played 1 year behind Jen Rosati. And got a lot of experience.
Playing behind Jim Rosati to do that. She makes one of two.
Keeping the ball out of Milena Flores' hand. Rita Williams just shadowing her. Talk about the 9 assists that she had in that first half, and a good play by Connecticut.
And a good play by Nakisha Sales, and she draws a foul on Peterson.
Thought that ball was just going to go out of bounds for Connecticut.
But Peterson instead was called for the foul, trying to go for the ball that was stolen from her, knocked away by Nakisha Sales.
And Nakisha Sales, in statistics, does not come up with as many steals as probably she could have because of the deflections.
That's true. Olympia Scott coming back in for Stanford.
Nygaard guarding Sales now in the second half.
Going inside to Sales. Good job of posting up down low.
And Heather Owen has to do a better job getting over there to help out. Connecticut used that a lot in that first half with Nakisha Sales posting down low and tossing it over their head.
And the steal to Williams! And that is the strength of Connecticut.
Rita Williams being very aware of stepping into the passing lane. Stanford has not done a good job protecting the basketball.
Williams again! Two steals in a row and two baskets!
That's her 30th steal of the season. She leads Nakisha Sales on this team.
And Connecticut now with a one-point lead. And double-teaming Williams and Sales, but Peterson gets away. But look at Sales. Williams ahead to Amy Durant. And she can't quite get it to go down, but she's fouled.
Coming out in the second half, Connecticut got scored against for the first basket, but they have picked up the defensive pressure, coming up with some big steals. Rita Williams, two in a row, pressuring the backcourt. That has been the youth and maybe the weak spot of this Stanford team in taking care of the basketball.
Flores has called for the foul. Ran at the line. Looking one of two. And Peterson going out.
Christina Modestini,
her first action in this game.
Moran has been perfect from the free throw line this year.
Two for two here. You see here, first half, 10 turnovers by Connecticut. They've yet to turn it over here in the second half. Owen from the top of the key, knocks it down.
Owen, 17 points already. A career high, 24.
Abrasimova, left alone.
Left alone, I said a little Matador defense there.
Wow.
Take the lane.
And Rita Williams call for the foul on Flores.
Foul number 23.
Rita Williams. Gina stalking the sideline, looking up. The fourth foul on Rita Williams. Paige Sauer is already out. Star Vandeveer's team down by three.
Stanford bench kind of discussing things. And Flores, a sophomore, was all Pac-10 freshman team last year.
Now with 10 points. Milena Flores, her team back to within one.
Improving the
play against Colorado the next game for Tara Vandeveer. And as I said earlier, that's all Tara wanted for Christmas was to have Kristen Fogle back, because in just 10 games last year, at the beginning of the year, she said she wasn't going to play. Tara went to her and said, look, we're hurt with injuries. Could you play? She comes and she leads the team in rebounding down the stretch.
Leads them in rebounding, averages 11 points, and shoots 70% from the floor.
A phenomenal athlete.
And smart.
Won 4 high school national championships in basketball and volleyball. Hansmeyer, offensive rebound, back out to Nakisha Sales, who backs up wisely and hits the three.
Talk about stroking, and she just feels so smooth in this game.
And the quick beat now of Nakisha Sales, who has 24 in the game.
Number
what Gino's worried about.
this team has done is a very streaky team all year long. They'll go an 11-0 run, just really giving them nightmares. But still, they're undefeated, 9-0, being tested here, but they have a four-point lead.
Well, they have three seniors on this team, and they graduated five people from last year. So they are young.
Olympia Scott, top of the key, back out to Flores. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Vanessa Nygaard, who drives too hard, and off of Olympia Scott, it'll be Connecticut's ball.
Olympia Scott really struggling in this game, who averages over 18 points a game and 7 and rebounds, and she has really been held in check.
Again, she's playing with 3 fouls as well. We approach the 15-minute mark here in this game. Again, a 4-point advantage for Connecticut.
Stanford throwing the zone out.
Kelly Hunt. Miscommunication there with Nikisha Sales. Thought she was going to cut. She looked right at her and said, go, Nikisha. And she didn't.
That will happen.
We've had those days. Trust me. Inside to Olympia Scott. The turnaround. I think she heard you, Annie. Stanford back to within 2. Nikisha Sales off the mark for 3. It's Olympia Scott who has a stolen, a scramble. Jump ball situation, the alternate possession.
The freshman, Abrava Zimova, coming around to the baseline. Olympia Scott looks like she comes up with a good defensive rebound. And there you see Abrava Zimova, up, knocks it away. And it goes back to Connecticut on the change of possession.
3 Huskies on the floor battling. That tells you something right there.
Abrasimova is such an active player, Robin. She at 6'2", and her youth, she really knows the game.
She's 17 years old. Inside the Hunt. Kicks it back out to Nikisha Sales. 3 seconds. Stanford's ball. Rare turnover over here in the second half.
And silly mistakes frustrate coaches.
So an opportunity here for Stanford to tie it with a 2 and take the lead with a 3. Nygaard being guarded by Duran. Give and go to Heather Owens. Did a good job of going to the basket and is fouled.
Foul number 22.
Nikisha Sales is called for the foul. That's her 3rd foul. So Sales with 3, Williams with 3, and Paige Sauer already out with 5 fouls. Be sure to join the Deuce Tuesday, 7 p.m. Eastern, when the defending NCAA champion Wildcats of Arizona, ranked 5th, will travel to Tallahassee to take on 17th-ranked Florida State. That's Tuesday, 7 p.m. Eastern on ESPN2. Sixteen points for Heather Owen. Above her 11-point average, and makes them both. First tie here in the second half. Rossimova looking to create, going inside to Handmeyer. Goes up strong, but is called for traveling. So 2 times down, 2 turnovers for Connecticut.
Stacey Handmeyer looks like she makes a good move in the middle. And that's what Connecticut needs, is get their post players involved inside, try to draw some fouls.
Battistini almost has it stripped by Abrasimova. And it's a little closer being, closer here in the second half, let's just say that.
It really has, and I think the players had adjusted to the officiating in the first half, and that's what a good player will do, though, is adjust to the way the officiating's going, and so it changes, and you have to be able to change, too. May not like it.
So Battistini will go to the line. 50% free throw shooter, making the 1st of 2. Averaging about 13 minutes a game.
This game has gone back and forth. No lead has been safe.
Though Stanford had an 11-point lead in the first half. But Connecticut, behind Gino Auriemma, cut that to 2 points at the half. A little moisture on the floor being taken care of. 18 years of coaching, Tara Vanderveer has won over 400 games.
439 games, 118 losses in 18 years. Forget that before her days at Stanford, she was at Ohio State, built a winner there as well. They were 34-2 last year in the Final Four, as Connecticut was in the Final Four. They were undefeated going in, had to match up against Tennessee in the Final Four, ended up with a 33-1 record. Amy Duran somehow gets it to Sales, who spins in the lane off glass. That is why she is a Player of the Year candidate. What a great move by Nikisha Sales. Sees the defense, feels it, and just spins out of the way. Now has 26. Heather Owens spinning baseline. Hits the favorable bounce. Heather Owens has been the go-to player in this game for the Cardinals so far. Averaging just under 12 on the season and has surpassed that. And the steal by Olympia Scott in the open court. A little bouncy, but it counts nonetheless. 20-second timeout, so we'll keep it here with UConn trailing by four. He wants some explanations. How do you explain this?
Well, she was on the World University team this summer. They won the gold. She was a leading scorer with plays and moves like this, averaging over 18 points. And then on the other side, Olympia Scott, who was also on that same team, makes a nice defensive play and gives herself 2 points, which she's been very quiet on the offensive end for the Stanford Cardinals.
Sales and Scott, only two of four collegiate players invited to the senior national team tryouts. And I find this hard to believe that Olympia Scott was the Pac-10 Player of the Week for the first time in her career last week.
For her career.
For her career.
She's only one of two players at Stanford that has started every game since a sophomore. The other was Kate Starbird.
She has been solid. Scott almost with the steal. Nikisha Sales off the mark. Flores wanted to give it up. Didn't see anybody down the floor. Away from the ball, the call, and the foul.
Calling an offensive foul on Olympia Scott, trying to get position on the push-off.
And that will be her fourth foul on Olympia Scott. Her team up by four. Come on back. Pavilion is so tough.
As Maple Pavilion for Stanford is.
That's right. Recently, their win streak was snapped by Tennessee.
Oh,
though it wasn't really at Maple Pavilion. It was at San Jose Arena. I know that. But technically, by the NCAA standards, it was a home game.
Believe me.
And
Pat
so now
Summit,
Connecticut has a loss.
Pat Summit was very happy about that. And so was Tennessee.
Under 12 to go here in the second half. Sails back out to Ruth Williams. Sales puts it up and hits the big three, going down on the back.
Great rotation on that shot.
She has 29.
Career high.
UConn within one. Inside to Owen. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Rita Williams a steal.
Stanford looking to get the ball inside to Owen. She's been shooting the ball well, and here's another player shooting the ball well.
And she is going to put it up and knock it down. Nikisha Sales, she's feeling it. With 32.
You've got to guard Nikisha Sales right now without the basketball. Make it difficult to get the ball in her hands and then put her in a position where she doesn't like to take the shot. And Stanford is not able to do it at this point.
With 7 seconds on the shot clock. Time ticking off. Owen has it flicked out of bounds. It's going to be Stanford's ball with 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
2 seconds.
And then set a career high for Nikisha Sales. 32 points. 6 of 7 from three-point range. And well above her average.
Ramana, I'm really surprised because I would think that she'd be scoring that many points a lot more. Her career high was 28 against Tennessee, but it's such a team-oriented offense that Gina Auriemma has, but Nikisha Sales is so capable of scoring that many points.
Earlier in her career, she had Rebecca Lobo. She had other people that she didn't feel she really had to step up. But now her senior year, she's taking those shots finally.
And she's going to have to continue to do it all season long.
She is very team-oriented, as is Vanessa Nygaard. Tough baseline J for Nygaard. Eyes at 64 all.
So far, the defense is allowing the shots. Nobody on Amy Durant. She gets her first points. Well, no, I shouldn't say that, but her first three-pointer of the game.
A three-point lead now for Connecticut and the ball. Sarah Dimson came back in for Olympia Scott. Ansmeyer turns, has it partially deflected. Amy Durant, though, and now Kelly Hodge. So Nygaard gets it.
Stanford just kind of standing around on the defensive end and just watching the play.
Remember the first half, Connecticut's got about one shot, and that was it. Heather Owens, strong move, but the rebound to Kelly Hunt. One on three, but the one is Nakisha Sales, who draws a foul. Connecticut likes its odds either one on three when the one is Nakisha Sales. And she'll go to the line.
We said in the opening, this is where she's most effective. In the open court, she handles the ball well, both hands. She sets the defensive up, just kind of change of pace right there and blows by Dimson and creates a foul.
And she goes to the line, a 72% free throw shooter. Remember, she started the season not feeling so well, came back from the summer having played international ball.
Kodak All-American last year, All Big East Defensive Player of the Year, two-time All Big East Tournament,
preseason biggest Big East Player of the Year.
Oh, yeah.
One of two Sales makes. Now a 33.
And a candidate for National Player of the Year.
A four-point advantage for Connecticut. Peterson for three.
Over the top, Connecticut ball.
It was over the top of the basket, and so it's Connecticut's ball.
Stanford just has to be a little bit more patient on the offensive end. Early in the first half, Amy Griffin had told us at Tara Vanderveer, said, look, you've got to get more passes around the perimeter. Be patient in the offense, and you've got to continue to do it in the second half.
Under nine to go here in this game. Brasanova looking inside the Sales. Gets it back out to Brasanova. Steps on the line, and so it's going to be Stanford's ball.
Vanessa Nygaard trying to make things happen on the defensive end. We talked about her being an emotional leader. The one year that Amy Tucker was the head coach and Tara Vanderveer was gone, and Nygaard said, all the cats away.
Yes, I remember her saying that. I think Tara remembered saying that too. Dimson back out to Peterson.
But they played themselves right into a Final Four.
Three consecutive Final Fours they have been to. Three times they've lost in the semifinals. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Heather Owens gets called for traveling. Last year, Tara Vanderveer and her team, I've never seen a team more shock after a loss than that ODU loss in overtime in the semifinals.
I really felt that Stanford was the best team last year, even though Connecticut going in was undefeated and Tennessee with 10 losses had a strong team and ended up winning the national championship. I really felt the way Stanford had been playing going into the tournament was strong.
And a dipsy doodle underneath by Nakisha Sales down with 35.
It was a strong move right there and a good defensive play.
Abrasimova and Rita Williams combining to force that turnover.
Two turnovers in a row for Stanford and also a bad shot selection. care where she takes a shot from, it's going down.
And the team came out to greet Nakisha Sales at half court. 20-second timeout.
It's really fun, Robin, too, to play with a player like that that is just on fire, and you know, no matter what they do with the basketball, they stay within the offense, but that shot is going to go in.
She's 15 of 24 from the floor.
You see the ball goes inside. Dibson, a defensive specialist, comes inside, and just a nice reverse down low. Here she's posting. Dibson up again. Little ball fake right there. Looks like she's going to go all the way into the middle. She pulls it back out again. On balance. Good shot selection. She likes it. I think Gino does too.
Like a
little Mr. Cobb. What is that?
Because I see this all the time in practice.
That's true.
Nothing new.
And this is the perfect time for Nakisha Sales to be coming out and doing it in this game.
Again, they were down by 11 in the first half. Melody Peterson going inside to Olympia Scott, and she's fouled from behind.
In the very beginning of the game, Stanford went inside to their post players. They have not done that in this second half. They tried to get the ball inside to Heather Owens. She's gone to the free throw line a couple times, but she has not come through with some shots. She was 5-5 in the first half, but if she has missed some easy shots, or even when she's fouled, those are the ones you've got to put down for a three-point opportunity.
The crossing over was called for the foul. Earning Scott a trip to the foul line. She makes them both. Timeout on the floor with Connecticut leading 72-66 with just over 7 minutes left to go in this game.
They shot 48% in the first half, and now they pick things up, taking good shots. Obviously, Nakisha Sales, 6 of 7 from three-point range, and 25 turnovers for the Cardinal, which is not helping the cause.
Time beginning to be a factor, though still with just over 7 left, and a 6-point difference. Anything can happen. Stanford coming off an impressive win at Illinois, and had all this week to be here to get adjusted. And they got off to a great start in the first half.
Stanford has switched defenses, trying to stop and sustain Nakisha Sales. They've switched night guard back on her. They've run zones at her. Do you double team her? Do you put a triangle on? You've got to try different things when you've got to play her that high.
Ansmeyer finding Ava Duran, who's underneath by Peterson.
But you cannot lose the concentration of other players on the floor for the opponent. Stanford that time leading Duran wide open. Nice pass by Ansmeyer when she had it down low, and Melody Peterson had to come over and just really hack her.
And that's the second foul on Peterson.
She does a good job not making Duran get the shot off.
And as if you've been with us, you know we're in a bonus situation because we've had a number of fouls here, so both teams from here on out. Duran making the first of two. And she is perfect from the line so far this season. Very 8-point margin now for Connecticut.
Connecticut doing a good job defensively, sagging inside and helping out.
Olympia Scott going high for that basket.
It's probably one player for Stanford that really needs to get hot, get the ball in her hand, and make things happen.
A Brossom over too hard. Owen with the rebound. And Nakisha Sales caused that turnover.
Does not come up with a steal, but as you said, Robin causes a turnover. She comes out of nowhere, and Melina Flores, looking to go down court, gets called for the travel.
And so it's going to be Connecticut's ball.
And Scott needs something like that to get her involved in the game, too, to make a big defensive play.
And this time, Peterson calls for the offensive foul. Rhea Williams gained Charlie Hunt checks in for Brasimova. Both coaches talking to their young players coming out, trying to make them understand. Gino Auriemma was telling us yesterday, and Chris Daly said, she understands what we're saying. Lakeisha Sales has scored half of Connecticut's points as Olympia Scott comes up with the steal. Has to pull out. The quick hands there by Rita Williams and Hansmeyer. But again, Stanford standing around. Robin Stanford, every possession have gone with a two-handed overhead pass to get the ball inside of their post players. And Rita Williams just sticks her hands up in the air. Lakeisha Sales with 39. Looking inside to Heather Owen. Two on her. On glass, but too hard. She's fouled and will go to the line. The foul on Kelly Hunt.
Connecticut
with Lakeisha Sales driving to the basket. She is so good at pulling up and not going past the zone of that charge. Good body balance. And on the other end, even though Stanford still not, their perimeter players passing the ball inside crisply and sharply to their post players. Owen makes them both. And again, the near steal by Olympia Scott. Lead for Connecticut, under five to go. Rita Williams looking inside. It goes to Amy Duran. Connecticut has a good lineup in there with Williams and Duran that can shoot the outside shot. They're looking to pass the ball around that perimeter, trying to get it to Sales. 1 second on the shot clock. Off the side. It's going to be Stanford's ball with a 30-second violation. Has to make a run starting here. They're down by six. They've got to create those that space in the passing. That time it was a good pass, but no offensive rebound. Connecticut doing a better job on the boards in the second half. Not quite enough oomph from Olympia Scott. 4 minutes left to go, 76-70 UConn. And that time element, like you said, Stanford looks like they're really kind of pressing themselves. Praise, but Rita Williams has had a super game too. Folks, Lakeisha Sales is putting on a show. The good foul by Flores. And so Lakeisha Sales will go to the line already with 41 points.
Gino Auriemma wanting a flagrant foul. But Milena Flores going for all ball, even though it's an aggressive foul.
Paige Sauer looks on with five fouls. Remember, she fouled up quickly here earlier in the second half.
And this is, we talked about Stanford, their spacing, the passing. Lakeisha Sales looked like she was just getting the ball passed right to her, and Flores stepping in front and going after the ball. Good foul. Lakeisha Sales makes it count. I don't have enough room on my board to keep adding the points.
I'm starting to ride at the table now.
And Stanford's not lost as far as seeing a player score this many points. Kate Starbird has scored when she was with the Cardinal, twice scored over 40 points. But to see an opponent do it, they're not too pleased about it.
Brasimova waiting to take back in. They'll be higher a little bit of Gina Auriemma.
You can only only survive in what you find in the forest. We'll meet.
A senior from Bloomfield, Connecticut said, it's my turn to turn it up this year. I'm the senior leader, and she's certainly doing it in this game, not only from the outside, inside, making great moves like that, penetrating to the basket, great control, 6 of 7 from three-point range, 3 of 4 from the free throw line, 43 points, 19 first half. And she has had a spectacular game, and I'm sure Gino Auriemma would like to see her continue it throughout the Big East.
And she is our Honda player of the game, 43 points. That is a UConn record, surpassing what Kerry Bascom was able to do in 1991. She had 39 against Toledo. But Nikisha Sales with 43 points. Stanford down by 12.
That Stanford has done, and Abrazimova goes right into the table.
She was hustling so hard and trying to save the ball that her back went right into the tables here on the sideline. She's going to be a little sore tomorrow, but
tries to save it. Great effort by the freshman. Stanford, we can't say it enough. I mean, this whole game, as far as their passing, their telegraphing, and two hands over the head is a definite telegraph pass, and they're spacing, trying to get the ball down to the post players. You've got to pump fake, and then give a bounce pass or a wrap pass to be able to use your left hand as well as your right hand.
Stanford with only 26 second half points, led by 2.5. And look at Connecticut. And they've done that all year long, really poured on in the second half. Connecticut is ranked, Stanford is ranked number 13. Olympia Scott is fouled.
Well, she stayed patient off the pivot, but just a shot that really she should have made that layup.
Number 20, Stacey
Hansmeyer is called for the foul. Later tonight here on ESPN after NFL prime time, we've got a prime time matchup between the 49ers. They've already secured home court advantage. Home field advantage.
Sounds good.
That sounds good. We're playing about talking about basketball, but football here, the Niners and the Seahawks at 8 p.m. Eastern here. Star Vanderbilt's team has been ranked in the top 25 every week since the beginning of the 1987-88 season. Number 13. If they're not able to turn things around with 3:05 left and down by 12, they will fall to 2-4 on the year. They opened up 0-2. Very young club, and they've been the team of the 90s. They've been to the NCAA tournament 5 times. 2 national championships in 90 and 92. 3 consecutive Final Fours. Under 3 to go now. Hansmeyer, too hard. Kelly Hunt is there.
Keisha Sales back in as well. Good play by the Huskies, just pulling it back out.
Time is definitely on the Huskies' side. Inside, quickly to Hansmeyer. Oh, and the baseline move too soft to Kelly Hunt.
Really got to give credit to Connecticut in the second half. What they did defensively, they sagged and stopped the post play of Stanford. They made it difficult as far as the passing was concerned, and the post players for Stanford just did not step up in the second half.
10 seconds on the shot clock. The clear out for Nikisha Sales.
Tough shot.
What do you mean tough shot?
Oh, that's right, it's Nikisha Sales today. 7 of 8 from three-point range.
She now has 46 points. Regan Druin. 86-73. 1:30 left to play. And Druin can only foul Rita Williams in the backcourt. You know, the Huskies will face all four Final Four teams this season. They've already played Notre Dame. They're playing Stanford now. They're going to play ODU, which you can see on ESPN, our Martin Luther King Day game at the Civic Center. They're expecting a sellout. And, of course, they'll play Tennessee in a few weeks. So a tough schedule again for Gino Auriemma and the Huskies. They're perfect on the year, 9-0, looking to go 10-0.
And that will be in Knoxville against Tennessee. You know what's interesting about last year, too, when they were undefeated during the season, and Gino Auriemma's team has really had a knock as far as the Big East. It's not that tough a conference, and yet they were undefeated, and he does play some good teams because he knows he has to.
Plays Georgia, goes outside of the conference, and plays tough teams.
But teams just couldn't believe that they were undefeated, and they kept winning games, and I think he was a little surprised, too. And he deserved National Coach of the Year. I mean, because of the type of season that they had the year before coming off of, it was a tremendous feat by his players.
Abrasimova goes out. Rita Williams makes her free throws, 88-73, a 15-point advantage for Connecticut. Battistini going with the left hand, too short. Now just playing keep away. Nakisha Sales.
15 points down, you never want to give up, but also in situations I think that the college players have to realize too, sometimes it's out of hand and the fouls as far as stopping the clock, your offense has got to be doing something.
Right, right.
And right now Stanford's offense, somebody's got to kick in to really make an effort to get close again.
Total now to 47. Actually, officially listed as 46. There was some discrepancy about a three-pointer. A minute left.
That's her third one.
Yes, 9 points for Fruin in this game. But still a 13-point lead for Nakisha Sales and the Connecticut Huskies. And you brought this up earlier. Her previous career high, 28, which was in that phenomenal semifinal game at the Final Four against Tennessee, when she scored that three-pointer to send her to OT. But she never really has had to be offensive-minded earlier in her career. Now she does. And she has responded. She came into this game averaging almost 18 a game. And leading to 46 points. And coming out of high school, she was a heralded about the pressures of the media because of the Rebecca Lobos and Carol Walters and Jim Rosati and that were there, and she was sixth man coming off the bench, and she averaged 11 points as a freshman and 4 rebounds, and now she is a senior. That now her game really is shining, and what a better time with pro ball looming in her future. Time remaining. Going for three. But the miss by Battistini. And the foul by Fruin.
Foul on number 15.
This is the first of two games that we'll see here from the Lakeland Center at 7 p.m. Eastern over on the Deuce. Iowa, the Big Ten tournament champions of a year ago, will take on once-beaten Vanderbilt. That's Iowa, number 8, Vandy, at 7 p.m. Eastern. On ESPN2, the second game of our inaugural Honda Elite Four Holiday Classic. Santar Vandeveer talking to her senior, Vanessa Nygaard. It's been a tough opening season. And a well-deserved round of applause for Nakisha Sales.
She really gave a show in this game today to the fans. I mean, it just was a lot of fun to watch. She had 19 points in the first half, kind of quiet too, but spectacular second half. She just was on fire, and anything she did touched the goal.
Inside to Olivia Scott. Marcy Glennie, locally Connecticut. And she is fouled. Marcy Glennie, just a freshman, went to Norwich Free Academy. Connecticut USA Today Player of the Year. Take a look at the bench of Stanford. Despondent
will drop to 2-4 on the year. And have another tough game against Colorado after Christmas, but as you said, Kristen Fulton will be back.
To our camera person about getting a shot of Rita Williams.
One. He's checking you out. He knows you're talking about it too.
He knows. When he makes them both. Thanks for joining us, everyone. This has been a presentation of ESPN.